Yeah, I mean, they showed tonight why the record is what it is and why they've been playing well and why they have a system that works. You know, they don't depend on just one player. I know Booker is their star player. But, you know, we fell asleep on Bridges. I think the Lakers got a little distracted with some of the calls that they didn't get, or some of the calls that were made. It kind of slowed down the momentum a little bit, and they just couldn't play through that. But, you know, tip your hat off to Phoenix, man. They played well. The Lakers were a little shorthanded, foul trouble. You know, Phoenix played well. They shot the ball extremely well, and the Lakers could not find a three-point tonight. They didn't shoot the ball well.
Better balance, by the way, too. Eight players on the Suns team, Fish, scored at least 8 points.
Yeah, it was interesting as this game started tonight. Jay Crowder hits a three to get it going for the Suns. Mikal Bridges comes back and hits a three the next possession. And you just kind of felt like, if the other guys are making shots early, it's going to be one of those kind of games. And, and, you know, once a team starts to feel confident and comfortable with making shots in your gym, it's hard to turn that water off. And this was a game that was more important for the Suns, you know, than it was the Lakers. Like, the Suns were trying to size themselves up. Trying to really see where they are. Can they compete with the upper echelon teams in the West? And even though there was no AD, no Gasol, et cetera, this was kind of one of those matchups they really, really wanted to get.
And take a look right there, Fish and James, at the role players for the Phoenix Suns. That right there is 14 of 24, 58%. You mentioned Crowder going 4 of 5, Bridges 3 for 6, Cam Johnson, Sarge, Nader off the bench go 7 for 12. First time all year a team has shot over 50% from 3 against the Lakers. And James, you can just look at the way the offense was going. 30 assists for the Phoenix Suns, just 18 for the Lakers.
Yeah, anytime you got CP3 on the floor, it's going to, you know, you're going to get efficient playmaking and efficient play. But I thought the spacing was really good. They went inside when they had to, especially when they tried to go small at the end. And Sarge, you know, went to work on anybody they tried to put on him. But this team came into the game shooting the ball very well, and they had those corners covered. Yeah. Anytime, you know, Booker collapsed or CP3 collapsed, they were there uncontested. The Lakers had to collapse on the defense to avoid the layups and the high percentage shots inside. So offense, you know, ran almost to perfection tonight.
And I think that's where Montrezl Harrell's minutes ended up getting a little bit compromised in this game. He obviously had to start, picked up an early foul, but this is my assumption. I'm not in the locker room or in the huddle. In the first half, in particular, that play to end the first half when Booker was able to get around to his right hand, kicked it out to the corner for three. I think the coaches felt like there was some trouble in navigating screen roll defense and being able to switch out, stay in front of Chris Paul, stay in front of Booker. And they decided to go away from that. Not a lot of minutes in the second half in particular, but still not, the Lakers weren't just able to really defend and keep this Suns team locked down.
Yeah, and then you look at the Lakers side guys and you look at their role players and just two guys that kind of jump off the page because they got a lot of minutes tonight are KCP and Wes Matthews. And a night like tonight, guys, with no Anthony Davis, no Marc Gasol, no Kyle Kuzma, but Devin Booker gets kicked out. This is a game the Lakers can win at home, but you need certain guys to hit shots because that's their job. And KCP and Wes Matthews combined for 49 minutes. They go 0 for 6 from 3, KCP 0 for 5, Wes 0 for 1, and just 1 for 9 from the field for 4 total points. Not enough.
Yeah. I mean, you're asking a lot from Pope and Wes Matthews. Without a fully loaded offense, you're kind of asking those guys to now ISO and do things that, you know, they're not accustomed to do. But and the shots that they're getting, I think, you know, they're feeling that pressure. You know, I don't think Wesley Matthews has scored in the last two or three games. So, you know, when you're in that kind of slump and you're not getting uncontested, easy shots within the offense, let's say if AD were in there where he was drawing two or three players. So what you're doing now, you're asking them to create, and that's just not part of what they've been doing.
And I also think in a game, you know, we've talked about without Anthony Davis, the Lakers have to play faster. Right. And so when you play against the Suns, you know, Chris Paul is, you're not going to turn him over very much. Hard to get easy shots before the defense gets set. Devin Booker's become such a solid ball handler. The Suns only 12 turnovers tonight, so not a lot of easy points from the defense. But just in general, in order for KCP, Wes Matthews, other guys to really find their rhythm offensively, the shot attempts can't be as low as 77.
Yeah.
Right? They have to get into the high 80s, 90s to really be able to spread that basketball around. If LeBron's taking 24 shots and going to the free throw
line, Schroeder's taking his shots.
Yeah, it's just not as much flow to the offense, a little bit too much standing around at times. Yeah. So look for the Lakers to maybe add some continuity, try to get a little bit more offense going for some of those other guys with more ball movement and player movement.
Big hero tonight for the Suns was Šarić, Dario Šarić. I mean, he kind of exploited a matchup that he found in the second unit. He took it to Dudley a couple times. He was trying to do a good job on him. Wes Matthews, he's matched up with a lot of different guys, but he was able to have 21 points tonight.
Yeah, I mean, he was a matchup problem. Like you said, at times, if the Lakers did end up switching screen role, he was taking smaller guys down, you know, having his way down in the post, getting good shot opportunities, knocked down some threes really well. And he had been struggling, you know, had an ankle injury that had, you know, had him off the floor for a while. But he's a confident player. During his time with the Philadelphia 76ers, he started a lot next to Joel Embiid. He can play. This wasn't a fluke tonight. He's confident, played a good game tonight on the road, helped the Suns get a win.
No question. When you go small and you have a versatile player like Šarić, who can go inside and punish you like he did tonight, and no Harrells in there to kind of, you know, reinforce that defense. Yeah, he had his way because he's big, he's strong, great footwork down there, up and under moves. He was a challenge that they couldn't match tonight.
All right, guys, well, let's get you to the highlights. Take you out.
At times, if the Lakers did end up switching screen role, he was taking smaller guys down, you know, having his way down in the post, getting good shot opportunities, knocked down some threes really well. And he had been struggling, you know, had an ankle injury that had, you know, had him off the floor for a while. But he's a confident player. During his time with the Philadelphia 76ers, he started a lot next to Joel Embiid. He can play. This wasn't a fluke tonight. He's confident, played a good game tonight on the road, helped the Suns get a win.
No question.